after 3 days and a half, the spirit of life from God entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them.
What this is all about is the true facts of the past, that the Israelites are coming back to rule the future kingdom on this planet Earth. The Israelites was chased out of the land of Canaan many years ago, according to this Bible, by the Greeks and the Romans. And they set up many churches and synagogues trying to be us, while we went into a negative setting of the Greeks and Romans to find out about the other side of what the Most High is showing us. He's showing us before we can bring the kingdom to educate us to the negative and the positive. Once we learn the negative, we will know how to set up the positive, which is righteousness on this planet Earth. And that's what this book is all about.
Great men with great ideals can be separated by hundreds or even thousands of miles and still be in the same place. They can be years or even generations apart in age, and yet somehow find themselves on the exact same page. When these men join forces with the focus of reaching the same goals to obtain the same outcomes, they are not two, but one. Instead of simply adding one's common attributes to another's, they somehow tend to multiply all attributes of both. Whether from St. Louis or East Atlanta, whether from a savage land or a booming metropolis, whether they are 2 or 2 billion, the greatest their numbers could ever become is to truly become one.
But as the body is one and hath many members, and all the members of that one body being many are one body, so also is God. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit. For the body is not one member, but many. If the foot shall say, because I am not the hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If the ear shall say, because I am not the eye, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If the whole body were an eye, where were the hearing? If the whole were hearing, where were the smelling? But now hath God set the members, every one of them, in the body, as it hath pleased him. And if they were all one member, where were the body? But now are they many members, yet but one body. And the eye cannot say unto the hand, I have no need of thee. Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. Nay, much more those members of the body which seem to be more feeble are necessary, and those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon these we bestow more abundant honor, and our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness. For our comely parts have no need, but God hath tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lacked, that there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care one for another. And whether one member suffer, all the members suffer with it, or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it. Now ye are the body of God, and members in particular. And God hath set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healings, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles? Have all the gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But covet earnestly the best gifts. And yet show I unto you a more excellent way.